Samsung's Galaxy Note is back from the dead, and it's better and safer than before. The Note 8 looks pretty similar to the Galaxy S8 and S8 Plus. It's got a slightly larger 6.3-inch infinity display with super narrow bezels on the top and bottom. The curved edges are even more subtle than on the S8. It's an intentional design to give you more of the display to use the S Pen on. The phone's made of metal and glass, and it feels as premium as ever. All the buttons feel great, but we're still not loving the dedicated Bixby button. Inside, the Note 8's rocking a Qualcomm Snapdragon 835 processor, 6GB of RAM, and 64GB of storage. The battery's somewhat small at 3300 mAh, but that's okay. Samsung says you'll still get a full day's battery out of it. And these batteries shouldn't explode. Samsung's putting them through a new 8-point battery safety check just to be sure. The Note 8 also has the same microSD card slot, fast charging via USB-C, fast wireless charging, and IP68 water and dust resistance. On the back, you'll notice there's a new dual camera system. Each camera is 12 megapixels. One is a normal wide-angle lens, and the other is a 2x telephoto. Just like the iPhone 7 Plus, there's a 2x mode called Live Focus on the Note 8 that blurs out the background. But unlike the iPhone's portrait mode, you can adjust the intensity of the background blur in real time. It's pretty impressive. But the Note 8's camera doesn't stop there. When you take a live focus photo with a 2x camera, the other camera also takes a wide angle photo. So you get both the DSLR-like shot and the whole scene. And get this, both cameras have optical image stabilization, so photos always look sharp even when you're zoomed in. As for the selfie camera, it's the same 8-megapixel shooter on the S8. For security, the Note 8 has the same iris scanner and face recognition as the S8. The fingerprint sensor is also still in the back, but it's not as close to the camera, so that's a plus. Software-wise, it's also nearly the same as on the S8. It's still running Android Nougat with Samsung's own skin, but honestly, it's not as bad as it used to be. The Note 8 does have a few new tricks though. The Apps Edge feature now lets you pair two apps together and open them up in split window. There's a live message feature that lets you handwrite and draw animated messages, and it'll save it as a standard GIF file. And the S Pen now supports full sentence translations as opposed to just words. All of these features really add up to the best Note ever. But will it be able to topple Apple's new iPhone? We'll have to wait until the phone launches on September 15 to find out. But so far, the Note 8 looks pretty impressive.